Morning, everyone. If you have your missalette, we're singing number 101. 101. Angels, we have heard a lot, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echo back their joyful strain.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we continue to celebrate this Christmas season, we do so still in the spirit of humility and gratitude to Almighty God, the gift of Jesus, who brings us forgiveness of sins. And so, in appreciation for that gift and with humility, we ask the Lord's pardon. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do. My fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son raised up your eternal light for all nations, grant that your people may come to acknowledge the full splendor of their Redeemer, that bathed evermore in his radiance, they may reach everlasting glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Beloved, we love God because he first loved us. If anyone says, I love God, but hates his brother, he is a liar. For whoever does not love a brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. This is the commandment we have from him. Whoever loves God must also love his brother. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this this way, we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep His commandments. And His commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. The word of the Lord. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. He shall govern your people with justice and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Lord, every man shall be loyal.
From fraud and violence he shall redeem them, and precious shall their blood be in his sight. May they be prayed for continually. Day by day shall they bless him.
Lord, every man shall be
His name be blessed forever, as long as the Son His name shall remain. In Him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nations shall proclaim His happiness.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord has sent me to bring glad tidings to the poor and to proclaim liberty to captives.
Alleluia, alleluia.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and the recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intensely at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers, my sisters, I'm sure that, like me, many of you sat in attention watching the television coverage of the events yesterday in our capital. And like many of you, a swirl of emotions were being raised in my own self, feeling things physically, emotionally, spiritually. And I thought this morning, wouldn't it have been nice if someone with a huge tractor trailer truck filled with speakers drove into the Capitol area and read the scripture we just heard proclaimed today in the first letter of John. If anyone says, I love God, but hates his neighbor, he is a liar. And whoever does not love a brother whom he has seen cannot love the God he has not seen.
Imitate God, who loves all of us, all the time, always.
Please stand. Trusting that the Father always hears the prayers we make with His Son Jesus, let us now present to Him these our cares, concerns, and intentions for today.
For vocations to the priesthood and religious life, may the Lord bless the Church with committed men and women. Let us pray to the Lord. Of Christ may touch all nations and lead them to understanding and cooperation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all struggling with mental illnesses, may the Lord bless them with the help and support they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those within our faith community who are unemployed, may the Lord in His mercy provide for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
The Lord hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in the hope of rising with Christ, may they soon rest in His peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
The Lord hear our prayer.
And for the repose of the soul of Donald Brown, remember especially in this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and an end of division in our country, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That each of us may accept our anointing and being sent forth to be heralds of the good news of the gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
good and gracious God, thank you for the opportunity to gather today in peace and to present you these and all the prayers we make in faith through Christ our Lord. Blessed be you, Lord, God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be you, Lord, God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which you brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for all the nations, and when He appeared in our mortal nature, made us new by the Lord of His immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Let us sing. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, we proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, Lord God, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in you, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
This is Jesus, who brings us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that by the power of these holy mysteries, our life
may be constantly sustained through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace and joy. The Mass is ended.
Amen.
Have a wonderful day.